Thanks for staying with us. I'm Bill O'Reilly in a personal story segment tonight. Anchorman or activist on August 25th in Iowa. Univision anchorman Jorge Ramos confronted Donald Trump on immigration. We don't have to play you the clips. Suffice it to say, there was a little tension. Everybody saw it. It's all over the place. Joining us now from Miami is Jorge Ramos. So tonight, I just want to get the audience to know who you are, Jorge. You know, they may be horrified, but I think I have to do it.
Maybe not. Maybe not.
Absolutely.
All right. They agree with me.
Question number one. Question number one. You don't want a border wall. You don't want that. Okay? Why not?
It's a complete absurd idea. Why would you want to build a 1,900-mile wall between Mexico and the United States if almost 40% of all immigrants come by plane and they overstay their visas? So based on some New York Times report, it would cost about $20 billion.
Right.
So clearly, Mr. Trump's problems, and maybe yours, is with Mexicans, not with Canadians. Why do you want a border with Mexico and not with Canada? It really doesn't make any sense.
It's a complete waste. We don't have an illegal immigration problem with Canada. Now, in Israel, they put up a wall to separate themselves from terrorists, Hamas, infiltrators, this and that. Mm-hmm. It worked. Millions of people have come across that border. Most notably recently, the man who killed Kate Steinle, who came across that border, Jorge, six times, Sanchez. So, for the benefit of all the people who would like to be safe, for Kate Steinle's family, I think we need to put up the wall.
Well, first of all, the problem with undocumented immigrants has been stabilized. In other words, it's been about 11 million people for the last 6 years. Now, you're talking about Kate, and let me say something first of all. I think my condolences to Kate's family. As a father, I cannot even imagine what they are going through. And as Kate's brother said yesterday in this show, the system failed. Having said that, that's why they're suing the county
and
the city of San Francisco. But this is where we have a difference between you and me. I don't think that what you are proposing is going to work.
We respect your opinion. You don't think it will work. I think it will work. Now, we want Kate's law, which would say if an aggravated felon, someone convicted of an aggravated felony in the United States, is deported and comes back, mandatory 5-year prison, can get more. All right, in a federal penitentiary. You support that?
No, because I don't think
you
are approaching the problem in a global way. And this is a problem. I'm not here to defend criminals.
You're an enabler, including Kate's killer, should be prosecuted
to the full extent of the law. However, the way what you are proposing, Bill, you would be putting in jail a mother or a father who got deported and might be coming back to see their children.
Aggravated felony conviction.
And you might be putting in jail.
Jorge, you not supporting Kate's law means that you don't care, because all your theory and all your stuff
isn't going to
stop.
I care about everyone here. I just think I don't agree with your idea. You have to concentrate on enforcement, background checks. At the same time, you have to resolve the situation of 11 million people in this country.
That's another matter, Jorge. You could chew gum and walk at the same time. It's another matter. Do you believe that Mexican nationals, and you were one, you came to the United States on a student visa, and then I guess you did everything legally, and you're here and you're successful. Do you believe that Mexican nationals,
just like you are,
Guatemalan nationals, Honduran nationals, have a right to come to the United States? Do you believe that?
If they have a right to come to the United States, if they do it legally, yes.
Okay, now, on the other hand, illegally.
You know why undocumented immigrants keep coming? They keep coming for a very simple reason. We give them jobs. There are millions of Americans, including you and the audience, who benefit from their work. That's why they are coming, and therefore we are also responsible for that.
All right, now listen. So you just said they have to come legally.
Absolutely.
They can't come illegally. But you, Jorge Ramos, will not punish those who have come illegally.
You want to criminalize a whole community for a crime that only one person did.
I want to hold people accountable, Jorge.
And then at the same time, we are also responsible. Do you not think they're just coming because they want to go to Disneyland? Of course not.
No, I've said that many times.
They are coming because
you don't want to hold them accountable.
Jobs that nobody else wants to do. We're giving them jobs. That's why they're coming, Bill.
But you can't have it both ways. You can't say they can't come come illegally, and then when they get here, say, that's okay, you can't do that. That's absurd. Now, last question.
You have here, you have a huge problem with 11 million undocumented immigrants.
And we can deal with it.
Who are not criminals, who are not rapists, and therefore, we have to find a solution.
And
you might not like the solution, but what
price.
You are proposing, it isn't going to work, Bill.
All right, I'm not for mass deportation, and you know it. All right, now, you're an anchor man. How can you possibly cover illegal immigration fairly when you're an activist, when you're a proponent of allowing them amnesty? How can you possibly cover the story? You should excuse yourself from it or recuse yourself from it.
I'm just a reporter.
Or become like me, a commentator.
I'm just a reporter.
You're not.
Asking questions.
You're an activist.
Mr. O'Reilly, I don't think you are the right person to lecture me on advocacy and journalism when you spend most of your program.
I'm a commentator, that's what I do.
Without asking questions. I can be tough with President Barack Obama and I can be tough with Donald Trump. But most of the time,
people can decide
you're siding
for themselves.
With Republicans.
They can watch your interview with Obama and they can watch my interview with Obama, and I'll tell you what. My interview was 100 times harder. Now, Jorge, why don't you just become
Bill?
Like me, a commentator? You're not a newsman anymore. You're an advocate now.
I am simply a reporting, asking questions.
You
but sometimes, as a reporter, you have to take a stand when it comes to racism, discrimination, corruption,
right.
public lies, dictatorships, and human rights. You have to take a stand, and that's the only thing I'm
Nobody
doing.
Nobody has ever been in a repertorial range like you have been. And I'm not criticizing you for your stand. I'm saying you're in the wrong job. Be a commentator. Now, I got to tell everybody.
What Donald Trump is doing is very dangerous. He's proposing
that's
the largest mass deportation in recent history.
Jorge,
and who's going to challenge him? That's our job as reporters.
No, a reporter reports, doesn't give an opinion. A commentator gives an opinion.
We report, but we also have to challenge those who
you
are
can
in
challenge,
power.
But
the
you
most important social responsibility of a journalist is to challenge those who are
Jorge,
in power.
You're doing exactly what I'm doing, man. You just don't have the title. Good
Thank
to see you.
You.
Thanks for coming on. We appreciate it.
And I appreciate this dialogue. Honestly, I think it's important that we have it. Thank
All
you,
right.
Bill.
Lou Dobbs on deck. He'll